On this video, we verify the following two trig identities. We're going to be proving trig identities, and for the one on this video, you'll need to know these identities, the fundamental identities and the Pythagorean identities, and you should know these well. All right, let's try to verify this identity. So I like to work on the side that looks a little more complicated, and to me that looks like the left-hand side because it's in terms of tangents and secants instead of sines and cosines. So I'm going to start on the left and put everything in terms of sines and cosines and see where it goes. So I have a negative 1 over, now tangent is sine over cosine, and secant is 1 over cosine. Now remember, you have to put the argument. You can't just write sine over cosine. You have to put sine of x over cosine x. Don't forget that. Well, hey, that's nice. I have a common denominator. So this is negative 1 over sine x minus 1 all over the cosine of x. And then I can multiply by the reciprocal. So I have a negative 1 times the reciprocal of what's in this denominator, cosine x over sine of x minus 1. Now I'm going to write down where we're trying to go so we remember. Okay, so remember, over here, this is what we're trying to get to. Now sine x minus 1, you know, if that was 1 minus sine x, we could multiply it times 1 plus sine x, and then we can get 1 minus sine squared and get that cosine squared somehow in there. So I'm kind of checking out. That's where I'm going here. Notice I've got a negative 1 here. So it doesn't matter where I put that negative sign, right? It could be in the bottom. So watch this. I'm going to switch that and write that as 1 over negative 1. And when you multiply negative 1 times this, you simply get 1 minus sine x. So now I'm going to go ahead and multiply numerator and denominator by 1 plus sine x. Alright, so let's see. Whoops, that went a little bit too far. Okay, so in the denominator, let's see, and so in the numerator I have cosine x times 1 plus sine x, and check it out. Look what I'm trying to get. I'm trying to get a 1 plus sine x in the numerator, so I'm getting closer. And in the denominator, I have a difference of two squares, 1 minus sine squared x, which, ta-da, Pythagorean identity is going to be cosine squared x. So that's in the denominator, cosine squared x. That's going to cancel with one of those cosine x, and we're almost there. So the last thing is, that's 1 plus sine x over cosine x, and remember, that's what we were trying to get. So we're done. So this took a little bit of writing. So here we go, back up to the beginning. All right, there's where we started. So we start with this identity, and we're just going to work on the left side, saying these are all equal until I finally get it to look like it is on the right side. So I started off by writing everything in terms of sines and cosines. Then I had a common denominator, so I just simplified the denominator. And then I multiplied by the reciprocal. And then I kind of finagled this since I had a negative 1. Instead of thinking of the negative cosine in the numerator, I wanted to rewrite the sine x minus 1 as 1 minus sine x, and that could only be if I multiply by negative 1, and there was a negative 1 there. So that worked out nicely. If not, if there was no negative 1, you could change that by multiplying the top and bottom by negative 1, and it would have been a different problem in that case. So we have then the cosine x. Then the next thing is, I want to get a 1 plus sine x in the numerator. See, you have to keep in mind where you're trying to get to. So how about if I just multiply the top by 1 plus sine x? Then I do the same thing in the denominator, and lo and behold, I get this Pythagorean identity in the denominator, and that gets us finally to our final answer. So again, try this all on your own. First, copy the way I've done it. Make sure you understand my steps, then get out your own piece of paper and start from the beginning and see if you could do it. And as always, this is just one way of solving this trig identity. There isn't just one way of doing it. As long as from one step to the next, you are using correct algebraic steps or correct trig identities. All right, this actually is a pretty easy one to do. So how about putting the video on pause and see if you can get this one on your own? Okay, I'm going to do it now. This looks fun. Well, obviously the left side's the more complicated looking one, so we're going to start with that. And I notice I have a sine squared times a cosecant squared. You know, usually I put things in terms of sine and cosine. Cosecant of x is, you know, 1 over sine of x. So cosecant squared x is 1 over sine squared x. These are reciprocals. When you multiply reciprocals, you get 1. Now, so you could either just change that to 1, or you could actually write that out. That's the same thing as sine squared x times 1 over sine squared x plus this other sine squared x all over cosine squared x. And then the sine squareds cancel. So I have 1 minus 1 plus sine squared x over cosine squared x. Ooh, beautiful. So that's sine squared x over cosine squared x, which is what we want. Look at, we want tangent squared x. That's exactly what tangent squared x equals. Ta-da! We just showed that we can do it. Wasn't that nice to do one that wasn't so crazy difficult? So sometimes you get lucky.